Hello, my darlings. It's been a busy day. I just had a visiting nurse from Swedish to go look at my mother, and then we have another person coming at 2 o'clock, and then at 3:30 we have a meet and greet with the new person who's going to be coming 4 evenings a week as mother's caregiver. To put to bed. I just got a parcel from Tom Lynch of Miskatonic River Press, and I'm having trouble opening it. I know what it is. So I was invited to write for this anthology, and I just didn't think I had a story in me, and so I told the editor, well, maybe I'll write you a poem, a holiday poem. Now, I wanted to write something Jewish. And then I went online and I saw a picture of the tomb of Oscar Wilde. And I saw how it had been disfigured with all those lipstick kisses, and that the oils from the fat in the lipstick were doing permanent damage to the stone with which Oscar Wilde's tomb was constructed. And so that inspired me. For the holidays, just in time for Yule. That inspired me to write a story. And so this is Horror for the Holidays, selected and edited by Scott David Anielowski. And I have the opening story. How wonderful. Thank you. It's always an honor to have the lead story. My story is called The Tomb of Oscar Wilde. I love the look. I love the lettering. So here's the beginning of my story. The Tomb of Oscar Wilde by W.H. Pugmire. It begins with a quote from Oscar Wilde's The Ballad of Reading Gaol. And alien tears will fill for him pity's long broken urn, for his moaners will be outcast men, and outcasts always mourn. Now I believe those lines of verse from Wilde's poem are also engraven on his tomb. "Why did you bring me here?" I muttered, looking away from the grotesque defacement. "I find the sight exceedingly depressing. Please, let us flee." But the poetess, who signs herself Seleno, merely laughed at what she saw as my dramatics. "Don't be absurd, Yakov. What you condemn as disfigurement are the authentic love tokens of countless admirers. To mar a poet's grave with graffiti is the opposite of admirable. How many of the fools who have pressed their painted lips against this tomb have ever read The Sphinx or The Harlot's House? Or," I pointed a long finger at her, "the grave of Keats. If they want to pay homage to Wilde, let them write a poem, but to blemish his tomb in such a manner..." I had heard about these ugly lipstick stains, but I had no idea there was such a plethora of them. They have marred this sacred place with their Judas mouths and killed the thing they love. Away, away. but my companion merely smiled and hummed a snatch of Chopin's Somber Prelude No. 24. Anyway, we shouldn't be here at this ghastly hour, and the last thing I need is to be arrested for entering this place past closing. How you knew about the other gate and the way in which to open it is a mystery I do not wish to think on. No, let us go, Rochelle. So this is the holiday I celebrate with this story is Kodesh. Rosh Kodesh, which is the celebration of the new moon, a Jewish holiday. So this is this looks like an excellent anthology, Horror for the Holidays, published by and available from Miskatonic River Press. Lovely. I also got a new book, Gathered Dust and Others by W.H. Pugmire. This is the leather-bound box set, and it's in slipcase, and it's really it's really packed in there. It's quite snug. I love this cover painting by Wayne Miller. It is just, and I love that lettering. This is such a handsome book. That the dust jacket is just perfect, and that illustrates the title story. And I got a lovely photo of me in punk drag. Now this is the leather bound edition. It's very smooth and nice. And comes with a sewn-in book ribbon. Okay. There is also, so this edition is limited to 26 signed by both me and Wayne. 26 signed copies. So then there is another hardcover edition. It doesn't have the fancy lettering on the front, but otherwise it's exactly the same edition. And so I'm just very, very pleased with this. However, I've been reading one of the brand new things in this book is called These Deities of Rarest Air. It's a prose poem sequence. Now I wrote this thing, These Deities, I wrote it at a time when I was extremely depressed. And it shows. It's not really. I was depressed about a lot. I was depressed about my congestive heart failure when I wrote this. I was dwelling on my old romance with a young man named Todd, and I was just really in a bad frame of mind when I wrote this thing, These Deities of Rarest Air. and it shows. I don't think the piece is especially good. And it, to me, it is a manifestation of a diseased mind and a sickened soul. And I've been reading it over today. As soon as I have a book published, I'm obsessed with reading it in printed form and finding any typos that Jeffrey Thomas and I worked really hard to proof this book. But and I did find one. There's some really weird phrasing in this piece. These DTs of rarest air. There's words that have been dropped. And there's one place in here where the word should be. Where is it? Maybe I can find it. The word should be especial, and instead the word that is printed is especially. Sometimes I have, you know, automatic correction on my Microsoft Word that's in my computer, and sometimes it corrects words, but the correction is actually not a correction, it's a mistake. Like once I wanted to have the word earthy, and I didn't know that Microsoft Word corrected that to earthly. It was totally, totally wrong. So anyway, but so much of this is a prose poem sequence, but I was in such a weird frame of mind when I wrote it that it's just kind of yuck. It doesn't make sense. It's the raving of an unhinged mind. It's full of self-pity. I shall never allow it to be reprinted. I don't think it's especially good, although it improves a bit near the end. When instead of short prose pieces, it becomes more short story. But then the ending, this is the ending. The very last piece. Piece 17. And this is how it ends. I caught my breath and felt afraid, for I had seen this shape in troubled dreaming, a demon that spun like a hungry thing as it coiled nearer to my eyes and stole their light. I shut my eyes and tried to ease my breathing, and when I scanned the skies again, I saw that the demon had altered in shape and was beginning to break apart. It was a cloud above me, nothing more. And I knew in that instant that there were no deities of rarest air, that such things existed merely in the songs of poets, in the ranting of lunatics and fools. There was nothing but this plot of death and its quietude, and the unyielding ground on which I stood, as implacable as mundane reality. There is no magic. There's just this boring, pathetic, hideous thing called life. This reality. Thank God this reality is a thing that ends too soon. It's just like, whoa, I was really messed up when I wrote this thing, my God. So it's a wonderful testament of self-pity and lunacy but it's just weird. Anyway, so this is the regular edition. I think there's still copies of this available, this hardcover, available at Dark Regions Press. He printed, I believe, 100 copies of the regular hardcover edition. And then, although I don't think this is going to be released until next year, this is the trade paperback edition. And it doesn't have the ribbon. And it doesn't have the photo in color, although it has the photo in black and white. And so I think the this paperback edition will be available once the hardcover completely sells out. And the book will also be available in Kindle, as an e-book. It'll be my first full book available as Kindle. But I'm pretty satisfied with it. There's a lot of reprints in the book of mostly of things that have not been collected in hardcover, and there's people that want my stuff in hardcover. So and a lot of these things appeared in The Tangled Muse, which had such a limited print run and was so expensive that I wanted these things in a less expensive edition. And then one of the stories is called Let Us Wash This Thing. Let Us Wash This Thing. And it's kind of a sequel to The Tangled Muse. So I have The Tangled Muse in the book as well, just before the Tangled Muse, and then it's followed by now Gathered Dust, the title story. The version that appears in this book is the second version of that story. Oh yeah, and there's a wonderful introduction by Jeffrey Thomas. But Gathered Dust, as it appears in this story, in this collection, is the second version. The very first version I wrote as an additional 10,000 words to my prose piece Uncommon Places, which appeared in The Tangled Muse. And so I Uncommon Places are prose poems and vignettes that are inspired by H.P. Lovecraft's Commonplace book. And so the Commonplace book dictated the plot of this story, Gathered Dust, which is a sequel to Javern and Shay's The Haunter of the Graveyard, or The Haunter in the Graveyard. So, for example, in one of the entries of Lovecraft's Commonplace book, it says something like, there's this strange man who lives near a graveyard, is not known to eat, how does he survive? And then there's another entry about a person being blindfolded and being driven in a cab to a secret rendezvous. And there's other elements from the Commonplace book. So the original version of this story is yet to be published, and it will appear next year in my second collection from Hippocampus Press called Uncommon Places. So what I did then, I completely rewrote the story for this hardcover, and I dedicated it to the memory of Jay Vrenchet, and I added some bits to it. So anyway, so I have lots of reading to do, and we have to get ready for more visits from people who are helping me take care of Mother. It's so nice to be able to talk like a normal person. It's my disease really affected the way I was talking for quite a while. And I'm feeling better. Still kind of weak. Need to take it easy. But it's nice to be home and relaxing. And it's wonderful, wonderful, wonderful to be published in a new... This is my third hardcover this year. First, I had The Tangled Muse came out in hardcover, the official edition, earlier this year. And then in summertime, Larry Roberts did the hardcover for Some Unknown Gulf of Night. This is my third hardcover. That's just kind of amazing. Wonderful. I'm very happy. So, I love writing Lovecraftian horror. It's what I live for, my darlings. Alright, I'm wishing you eldritch dreams. Thank you, Tom, for the two copies of Horror for the Holidays. And I'll see you all later. Shalom.